The Astrodome in Houston, Texas, the site of the 39th annual All-Star Game. And there you see the immense crowd here. The record attendance was in Indianapolis 4 years ago, 43,146. And we could approach that or surpass it this afternoon. The officials working this game, Hugh Evans, Bill Saar, and Dick Bavetta, and they are rotated, but they are chosen by their efficiency. So the best officials work these games. Michael Jordan, last year was his game, Hubie Brown, and Dominique Wilkins always in the picture. Tom Chambers a couple of years ago in Seattle, and of course we will always discuss as the game moves on possible MVP, because that becomes a big one.
As you look at who can excel in this kind of a game, the guards and the small forwards, because they have the ability to beat you off the dribble and create things for themselves and get out in the open floor. Transition game, a la big time playground.
And there's talk about that. Isaiah Thomas, who has won two Most Valuable Player awards. We're underway. The West in white, the East is in the dark red, and Dale Ellis from Alex English puts the West ahead quickly.
The coaching staffs are just putting in like three or four simple sets, allowing the players to get a catch in a certain area so that they can do their one-on-one moves.
Moses Malone is posting up against Akeem. Barkley takes the shot and misses. Elijah on the rebound. John Stockton, the only true point guard on the West Stars. And you're going to get some of that too, a turnover, because they only really went through paces for 45 minutes yesterday.
Well, it's unfortunate for a player who's accustomed to getting 20 some odd shots during a game during the regular season. He's getting the ball delivered to him from players who are accustomed to him making his pet moves. Here, the guys are just getting a feel for one another.
And we'll have our first foul of the game as Dominique Wilkins began his move. And it's against John Stockton. As you saw, the East has won 7 of the last 9 and have a 25-13 edge. But what's interesting is that in the last 12 years, only one game has been decided by more than 10 points, and that was the game in Indianapolis. So we're always in for close affairs here.
Well, it's the competition. Everyone wants to excel, and when they get out there, their motors are going and wide open.
Here's Dominique Wilkins, who's been bothered by a dislocated thumb.
He missed a few games for the Atlanta Hawks, and he gave it a run against the Knicks the other night, but he has difficulty holding on to the ball.
Michael Jordan with a steal, a 3-on-2 break, no-look pass. Now Isaiah Thomas. Barkley scores and ties the game.
I would think that the ultimate compliment to my talents today would be, you know, I score my points, but more important, that people are going to remember me for my passing.
Well, if the West scores, then they'll have a tie. Alex English in the lane. He's guarded by Dominique Wilkins. Good play again by Wilkins. He made the defensive play that time. Look at that pass. You're going to see some of that. It's showtime early here. Elijah Wan. Stockton on the drive. And we're tied now at 4. Got to rise out of the crowd early here as Thomas Hearns, one of the celebrities watching the game. Moses Malone misses. And here come the West again. Dale Ellis with a wide open jumper. He won the 3-point shootout yesterday. He finished 2nd to Larry Bird last year. He has been Seattle's big gun.
Bickerstaff sums him up great, calls him a man of great courage.
Isaiah Thomas comes back with the basket. Thomas disappointed that Magic Johnson isn't here. Steal again, this time Wilkins. Oh, 360.
Left it a little short, though.
Stockton getting in. They're working out the kinks early here. Akeem Olajuwon. You know you'll hear a cheer. Anything that Akeem does today. Right now they're trying to get the timing down. And of course, you see many All-Star games, and this is no surprise. Stockton all the way with the drive. And we're tied at 6 with 9:15 to go opening period.
You're always worrying about court balancing games like this. You just want the guys to get back so they have a little bit of resistance, so that it just doesn't become up and down.
Barkley fights his way in. Charles Barkley, he had some comments about the Atlanta Hawks, but they're kind of friendly. Moses Malone and Barkley were kidding in practice yesterday, as Karl Malone, he had a big game last year for the West Stars. 10-8, the West in front. They won 2 years ago in Seattle in overtime in the Tom Chambers thriller.
There's pick and roll now. Michael Jordan, Moses Malone.
Oh!
Barkley follows up. Charles Barkley asked him, do you want to be MVP? He says, I guaranteed my teammates on the Sixers I'd get 10 rebounds. That's what I'm shooting for today. He wants 10 boards. Olajuwon with his first basket.
Hakeem Olajuwon is the only guy in this league who is in the top 10 in four categories.
Pretty good testimony there. Moses is fouled inside.
On the offensive boards, Charles Barkley is leading this league. He's ahead of Moses Malone. This is what he does best. Very, very difficult to hold out because of the upper body strength.
Well, here's Moses. Moses said the five most selfish players on the 76ers were Barkley, 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 and he said it five times. But he was kidding yesterday. They're former teammates with Philadelphia. Moses has been around a long time and a new home with Atlanta. How do you think he's made out so far and with the Hawks and fit in?
Well, I think it's difficult for them to get it together so quickly. I think in the second half of the season, you're going to see excellent execution with Theus and with Moses Malone.
Ronnie Lott of the world champion, Super Bowl champ, 49ers independence. Alex English scores. All five starters for the West are in the scoring column. Loose ball, and here's a 3-on-2 with Karl Malone leading the way. They're not going to contest him. No way.
We don't see that very often. 2 6-foot-9 guys on the fast break handling the ball.
Well, you know, there's a point guard spot to fill after John Stockton. 16-12, the West in front. 7:45 remaining first period. Dick Stockton and Hubie Brown with the game action for you. Here's Dominique. Karl Malone takes up so much space. Both ends inside.
Look out.
Karl Malone, who was the top scorer with 22 and rebounder with 10 for the West last year in a losing cause. And now we'll have our first time out of the game.
Watch Malone. You can see him coming here now. He's really gone on the weight program. He says, I can do anything better than everyone else because of my stamina.
Timeout early.
How fast does Dristan nasal spray start to work?
Faster than Dolly can pick up a $5 tip.
Dristan works fast to relieve nasal congestion, even sinus pressure. For relief,
faster than a fan on a hot day.
Try Dristan nasal spray. It's faster than...
Attention all men with noses. Introducing Schick Slim Twin Disposable. It's 28% slimmer than Good News to give you a close shave even in hard-to-reach places. New Schick Slim Twin, preferred by men who have noses.
Yo! This is Morris Blackman, and this is my main man, Michael Jordan. And this is a pair of tight Air Jordans from Nike. This is something you can buy. And this is a patented, vicious, high-flying 360 slam dunk. This is something you cannot do. Let me repeat myself. This you can buy. You cannot do this. Can. No!
I'm not going to sit here and tell you AT&T's long-distance rates are competitive. I'm going to prove it to you. If you're with another long-distance company and your business spends at least $120 a month, call us about our discount calling plans, AT&T Pro Watts. If you qualify, here's the deal. We'll pay for the sign-up fee, the switch-over charge, and if within 3 months you're not completely satisfied with our quality, value, and price, we'll even pay to switch you back. So what have you got to lose? Even the call is free. 1-800-222-0400. Pick up the phone. Call us.
Well, this year our focus will be on the parents of the players and how they reflect on the childhood of the all-stars we see on the court this afternoon.
One of my habits used to be working on cars. You know, I'd always keep my old car to tinker with around the house. And I could always take my other boys out and I could say, give me a 9/16 wrench or a pair of plows or something like that, and they'd go right to it. Well, I could tell Michael to give me a 9/16 wrench and he might bring me a adjustable wrench this large, you know, and I'd always say, you and your big ears, go back in the house with your mom, you know, you'd make a better cook.
I think the opinion of this man by his peers and the coaches and the media, he deserves all of his success. He handles it so beautifully. He has time for everyone.
John Stockton has time for him as he slapped the ball away in the West. Stockton, by the way, with 4 assists in the game, making the most of his starting opportunity for Magic Johnson. Alex English misses, but there's the mailman again, Carl Malone, who has 8 early points, and it's a 20-12 West advantage. Block inside by Akeem. And gets congratulations from the rest of his teammates.
In the early going, you have to really appreciate what Isaiah and Stockton are doing. They're pushing the ball. They're not worrying about a stamina problem.
Inside, reverse bank by Michael Jordan. His first basket. And Ellis now with 6 points. He was the named most improved in the NBA 2 years ago, and later on we'll see Kevin Duckworth of Portland, who was most improved last year. Jordan didn't get the foul, and Moses Malone misses the rebound. So now it's a 4-on-2 break again, and Ellis scores and gets the foul. So 18 of the 20 points, 24 points, have been fast break for the West.
Ellis is a very difficult cover. You're talking about a guy who's at 6'7". Anytime he's out on a break, you never know if he's going to stop up and hit that three-point shot, take a medium jumper, or take you to the basket. Played forward in college at Tennessee and really has a dynamite low post game.
And you got to remember, he was acquired by Seattle for Al Wood in a trade with the Dallas Mavericks.
Sat on the bench for a number of years at Dallas, never got an opportunity.
Dominique Wilkins works his way in. Wilkins was the second leading scorer last year to Jordan. Jordan got all the headlines, but Wilkins had a pretty fine game. The lead is 9 for the West. Nearly halfway through this opening period, and Stockton and Ellis get crossed up, and the East will take over again.
See, the pressure for a point guard is that as you're coming off picks, what they're doing is they're trying to anticipate where you're going to go. That time, because of the way he was defense, Stockton thought that Ellis might fade to the corner.
Alley-oop. Patrick Ewing in the game, and Ewing gets the basket.
Now, that was brute strength. Very, very strong move for Patrick.
So Patrick Ewing in the game for the East. Feed inside to Elijah Wan, blocked by Ewing. And they're going to tie him up and jump him, and Patrick Ewing tied up Akeem Olajuwon on a stuff attempt, and that's the defensive play thus far.
That was so difficult because watch the pass. It's a great pass, and Olajuwon tries to dunk this with both hands, so you know he's going strong. That takes strength.
That is an all-star play by an all-star against another one, and the tip won by the East. Oh. Great pass from Isaiah to Barkley.
Did he send a little message there on that dunk?
So Karl Malone and Charles Barkley have been big people inside thus far. The point guards have set him up. But Ewing's block, we'll remember that a while. 25-20 the West. Alex English, so smooth.
The quietest scorer in this league. At the end of the night, you think Alex at 20 usually has about 38 or 39.
Thomas finds Barkley again, and there's Charles. He draws the foul this time around. And Kareem is going to come in the game to a big hand.
Isaiah Thomas has made at least 4 great passes so far in this game. But on this jump ball, watch how he catches and leads at the same time. Constantly looking to push the tempo of the game.
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and Clyde Drexler have come in the game. Terry Cummings of Milwaukee in for the East. So Drexler of Portland, who of course was part of the Phi Slamma Jamma team with Akeem Olajuwon. There he is at the University of Houston is in. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Cummings having a great year for Milwaukee. There's Terry. Had a chance to chat with him the other day. Says he enjoys the game the most he has in the last several years.
Well, he really feels that he's been revitalized. He feels over the last 3 seasons. He thinks that the Milwaukee Bucks are for real and will definitely continue at this pace in the second half of the year.
Winding down to 5 minutes to go in the opening period. Drexler. Here's English. Alex English.
That's his shot. Anytime Alex gets you down on the baseline, he's murder. It's a feathery touch.
He was traded from Indiana for George McGinnis. Let's not forget that deal. Talking about steals.
Hey, wait a second. Alex English was a second-round draft choice. How about that?
Charles Barkley inside. I like the way the East is getting the ball inside to Barkley thus far.
The open floor game we expect. The unselfishness part of this game will come with the perimeter people, both guards and the small forwards, distributing to the big forwards and centers. Because when you play big forward or center in an all-star game, it's really difficult to excel unless the other guys are totally unselfish.
Karl Malone committed the foul on Barkley, who is a newlywed. Maureen Lynn Blumhardt, his new bride. And we have already learned, Hubie, that we have established a new record. New attendance record for the NBA All-Star Game. Tom Chambers goes in now for Karl Malone. 44,735, the largest in the 39-year history of the NBA All-Star Game. And there you see the numbers, the top attendance figures, and we've broken it, shattered it today.
Oh, you have to take your hat off to the people of Houston who have really supported this, and then the outstanding job by the NBA commissioner's office.
It's turned into a huge event. Clyde Drexler misses outside. Chambers having a big year with Phoenix. Beats Alex English. English and Malone have 8. Ellis 9 for the West. And Charles Barkley with 11 is the leading scorer for the East. Ewing missed, trying to go strong. And here comes Stockton in the West Stars. Beats English. Nifty basket.
That was beautiful because Stockton read. He turned his head. Knew Alex English was behind him on the break. This reminds me of John Stockton at Gonzaga College. John playing with four guys over 6'8".
Inside, Michael Jordan with his second basket.
That was a mini showtime. Just a mini.
Yeah, he's just warming up. Under 4 minutes to go, opening period. There's Kareem against Ewing. All right, skyhook. Usually it's from the other side, though. Barkley again crashing the board. Now the West should have an advantage. They have 4-on-2 against the East. Chambers from Stockton. They'll call goaltending against Patrick Ewing, who nearly blocked another one.
On this sequence, watch Zeke hit Michael going on a backdoor move, and here it is. You thought he was going to do a 360.
Cummings misses. Stockton the rebound. Runs into a stone wall in Terry Cummings. And the foul will be against Cummings. There's James Worthy of the Los Angeles Lakers. And Chris Mullen of the Golden State Warriors. One of the great stories. Last year, he was watching this All-Star game on a stationary bike, recovering in alcohol rehabilitation, and now he's an All-Star. Larry Nance of Cleveland coming in for the East Stars.
Speaking about Mullen, yesterday Dick Burke, the assistant coach of the Lakers, went over to the gym in the late afternoon at the YMCA, and there's Mullen's pumping iron in the late afternoon after working out in the morning.
What a great recovery. Misses his first attempt. Ewing lost it out of bounds.
Now the West team at this time will have Drexler and Mullen in the backcourt position, so they do not have a true guard here right now.
Brad Riley, who told us in the pregame show, he says, I'm still depressed over the Magic Johnson loss, not only in this game, but for the year. You don't have to worry about the 24-second clock.
No, not today.
Chambers misses. Ewing with a good outlet pass to Isaiah Thomas. The West is back, however. Isaiah, wide open is Larry Nance. Threw up an air ball. Here's Cumming. They're inventing shots out there, Hubie.
Looks a little bit like volleyball.
So you talked about the backcourt up front. It's Worthy, Chambers, and Kareem, and Worthy. Patented move for James. Barkley, by the way, on the bench with the substitutions, has 11 points as the leading scorer in the ball game. Alex English has 10. He's out as well. Thomas with a move past Mullen. Lost control. And it'll be the West. And a timeout with 2 minutes and 12 seconds to go in the first period. Just the start of a big day. It's the All-Star game.
Pure. Genuine. Never heat pasteurized. A beer that's made unlike any other. Cold filtered to give you the rich, smooth taste of real draft beer. That's the mark of a great beer. Cold filtered Miller Genuine Draft. It's as real as it gets.
No bull. worldwide information systems.
Give me a hot, dusty day any time of year. Give me my favorite Ford and mud up to here, because I love getting dirty.
Love getting dirty.
Yes, I love getting dirty. So give me rain and puddles in my 4x4. Give me a brand new Ranger and I'll never be bored, because I love getting dirty.
A newly designed Ford Ranger.
Yes, I love.
Get 4.9% financing or up to $750 cash bonus on 89 Rangers.
From Norway, the world crowns its speed skating king of the ice. From Hungary, the IBF crowns its welterweight king of the ring next weekend on CBS Sports Saturday.
We have a record crowd of 44,735 for an All-Star game here at the Astrodome. They haven't played a basketball game here in 17 years when the Houston Rockets played 8 games. And you're looking at the view from the left field line into home plate. Of course, the home of the Houston Astros. And there is the famed Skyliner. Remember when they first played an exhibition game here, everyone was losing fly balls. I think the Yankees played an exhibition game here. And there you see the Astros division championships in 80 and 86. John Stockton set a new record with 9 assists in the first quarter. That's most assists in a quarter. Mark Price is in, though, for the East Stars as we continue with 2:05 to go. Chambers going up, draws the foul.
Beautiful pick and roll that time. Drexler has a second guard here coming off the pick and roll. Beautiful feed.
So Chambers will go to the line, and he was a free agent. What about the acquisition of Chambers and what it's meant to Phoenix this year?
Well, anytime that you get a quality player who can get you 25 to 35 points and you don't give up any draft picks, any type of a quality player, you add that with the trade that they made last year, the development of Herman Gilliam at the power forward position, and then 3 to 4 really terrific young rookies. And let's never say that Cotton Fitzsimmons hasn't done one of his best, maybe his best coaching job since he's been in the NBA.
That's great for him. They're the leading scorers, Barkley and English. Chambers with the free throws. He was originally a number one pick by the San Diego Clippers. Patrick Ewing gets inside, tipped up and in by Larry Nance. And it's 39 to 27, the West leading by 12 with under 2 minutes to go in the first period.
See, in the early going, the West, they're making things count. They're taking good shots. They're not trying to do anything spectacular. That was good, good. I tell you, from our advantage that time, I thought Patrick really took the charge. And when you think about that a second, this is an All-Star game, and Patrick Ewing attempts to take the charge here. Now, this is a pretty tough move. Very close, you know. It depends upon the angle that you were looking at that one. Sure, they don't care whether they win or lose.
No, that's why they're throwing their bodies around the floor. So Ewing picks up the foul, and Chambers again on the free throw line. He said, you know, a couple of years ago it was a storybook story for me, you know, the MVP award in Seattle, the hometown. He says, you know what, now I want the West to win again like they did 2 years ago. 41 to 27, 14 point lead. That's the biggest lead thus far for the West All-Stars, who are playing without the Magic Man. And Drexler made a good defensive move, one after another.
Two terrific defensive moves. Michael Jordan beats his man off the dribble. You saw a great rotation, and then another rotation. We're going to see it all here today because of the quickness of foot and the shot-blocking ability.
Jordan, quick shot. Rebound Chambers. How would you like to have these guys work them for about a couple of months and then go out with them, huh? See what you can do with them. Price is on Drexler, giving up a lot of inches. Chris Mullen, double team. Having trouble with the ball, and it's stolen away by Mark Price. Open court is Michael Jordan. Oh! Ha-ha.
Gave it and took it back, and then soft layup. Fingertip roll.
41-29, under a minute to go, first period. The West is led virtually all the way. Drexler comes right back at him. Can't do it, and there's Jordan in open court. He gets the basket. Michael Jordan with 8 points now. Former Sixer Bobby Jones. He used to run the court pretty well and play fine defense for Philadelphia.
Listen, Bobby looked good yesterday in the Legends game. Got double figures, almost won the game.
Worthy hits one from outside with a half a minute to go. 7 different West players have scored. English leads them with 10, although he's on the bench right now. Good penetration by Price. Cummings can't get the roll and the rebound by Chambers, and he's hacked under the basket with 19 seconds to go in the first quarter. There's a legend talking about one.
John Havlicek, one of the all-time greats. Could play guard, could play small forward. At the end of his career, he's still knocking in double figures, shooting a high percentage. And then the big thing when you think of Havlicek, you think of a guy who laid it out there every night with his heart. And never got tired.
And never worked up a sweat. They're in the penalty now, and Terry Cummings picking up his second personal foul. Tom Chambers, who's made a living on the line in this first period.
Tommy's having a nice game. When he was drafted out of the University of Utah, he was a major big-time center. Went down to San Diego. They played him at big forward and small forward, and his game really blossomed when he moved up to the Seattle area.
Chambers now with 8 points in the game, has hit all six of his free throws. And now playing for the final shot of the first period are the East Stars. Mark Price. This is long range. Kareem. Mullen by way of Worthy. And Mullen is fouled by Mark Price, and he'll shoot him with 5 seconds to go. Here's a guy who makes his living in this Astrodome, Warren Moon, the fine quarterback of the Houston Oilers. Let's talk more about Chris Mullen, not only the comeback, but what he has meant to the Golden State Warriors.
I too.
Don Nelson right now is playing four guards. Teagle at 6'5", Mullen at 6'5", Richmond at 6'5", Garland at 6'1", and anchoring it with a 6'7" center. You can only do that if you have people with great vision. And Don Nelson told us that right now, this young man, Chris Mullen, is one of his all-time favorite players that he's ever coached. He has incredible court vision, great unselfishness, is never in a hurry to do anything, and very seldom will ever take a bad shot.
And there were questions about his pro ability, if you remember, as well. He answered those, as did Mark Price, who misses the last shot of the first period. Just the start of things, but the West with a 16-point lead, their biggest of the game, and a high-scoring affair it is. After one period, we're in the books in Houston.
Morning, Walter.
Tom Hanks has brand new neighbors.
Neighbors from hell.
They're not Ozzie and Harriet.
Your neighbors are murdering people.
They're not the Cleavers.
Got somebody tied up in the old cellar, have you, Ruth?
They're the Klopeks.
These Klopeks are strange.
And they're living in...
This is Walter.
The Burbs. Tom Hanks.
I think we are overreacting.
The Burbs. Rated PG. Starts Friday at theaters everywhere.
A recent Department of Energy study reveals that most American homes are under-insulated. And that means you. To find out what's right for your home, call Owens Corning at 1-800-GET-PINK.
Attention all men with noses. Introducing Schick Slim Twin Disposable. It's 28% slimmer than Good News to give you a close shave even in hard-to-reach places. New Schick Slim Twin, preferred by men who have noses.
So are you doing all right?
Yeah, I'm doing fine.
Dad was afraid I'd find a starving artist up here.
Oh, Dad was worried.
Okay, I admit, I was a bit worried when my little sister took off on her own.
I'm not so little anymore.
Here, let me get that.
No way, mine.
American Express, huh? I'm gonna stop worrying about you.
Making you feel like a million. To become a member, look for this display and take one.
What's it take to be a most valuable player?
Taken by Magic. Magic in deep. Finger rolls it up. It's good.
It takes drive, determination, and a lot of team spirit. It's that same team spirit that makes the designated driver a most valuable player. So before you go to a game, choose a designated driver. Someone you can count on to get you home safely. That's who gets my vote as most valuable player.
The designated driver. Someone people really look up to.
Sports coverage of the NBA All-Star Game is sponsored by Wheaties. The natural goodness of 100% whole grain makes Wheaties the breakfast of champions. Minute Maid Orange Soft Drink, the orange of the NBA. And by Jeep and Eagle, official vehicles of the NBA.
The scene is the Astrodome, part of the big NBA All-Star Weekend in the city of Houston. CBS Sports presenting the 39th annual All-Star Game. Dick Stockton and Hubie Brown and Pat O'Brien and James Brown with us today. And there is the crowd of 44,000 plus and a man who really needs no introduction.
Now, all the accomplishments. Only two players in the NBA have ever started in this game 11 consecutive times. And that, Dr. J and Bob Pettit from the old Hawks.
James Worthy on the steal feeds Clyde Drexler. That's quite a distinction. Substitutions in the game. Mark Jackson of the New York Knicks in the backcourt. He's teamed with Ewing. Brad Daugherty of Cleveland also in there. Mark Eaton, the big 7'4 giant in for Utah. And there's Mark Price fouled by Chambers. So the two Knicks are in there at the same time.
I'm really happy for Drexler right now. Here goes Clyde Strong. That's one of his, the slam and jam him and you name him. All right, and he was in the finals yesterday in a slam dunk. I'm happy for him because he grew up here on the south side and is really a playground legend in around Houston.
Sure is. Ewing misses. By the way, Kenny Walker of the New York Knicks won the slam dunk contest. So Chris Mullen, along with James Worthy, Chambers, Eaton, and Drexler. Drexler too far under the basket. So the backcourt again is Drexler and Mullen. That's work for the West. Jackson leaves it for Ewing.
Watch out.
You can get hurt that kind of way. And
24.
Michael Jordan on the bench right now. He scored 8 in the first period.
See, if you're a fan today and they throw all these lob passes, you're really very, very happy, okay? The only problem is if you're coaching one of these players and you're sitting at home watching on TV or in this building, you do not want to see a lob in traffic.
You think Rick Pitino right now went into another room when he saw that play?
I think he'll remind Mark Jackson about this when they meet up on Monday.
He says, guys, we're in first place in the Atlantic Division. That's not spoil a good thing. Patrick Ewing misses both free throws and Drexler. Chambers going strong, stuffs it through. 10 points for Tom Chambers. He and English lead the West, and Barkley, who is still on the bench, has 11 points to top the East. Jackson and the rebound by Worthy. Chambers filling the lane. Good feed. No, stolen by Jackson. They were looking for Mullen.
Oh, yes.
Behind, under the legs, leaving for Price. Nance picks up his own miss. 51-33. The West had it up to 20. The West has dominated this game.
Well, they're looking inside to try to take advantage of Price on Mullen.
Chambers again. 12 points. Does he want another MVP?
You know what I like about Tommy? Never mind the fact that he's scoring all these points. He's doing a great job on the boards at both ends of the floor.
And a 20-second timeout called by the East.
On this possession, you'll see the shot go up, and here's Tommy being very active, coming in strong. Can release with either hand, left or right. What I like what he's doing down there at Phoenix, you know, they do not have that many experienced players, especially guys with playoff experience. And he's a great aid to show these young guys how to work and work hard.
They're the most improved teams. They all have played extremely well this year. And there is the man who deserves so much credit. He doesn't like to hear it, though. He's, I think, embarrassed by it. But you've got to credit David Stern to make this thing a gigantic show.
Well,
in the league, to say the least.
Well, think about it. Back when he took over, only 6 of the 23 teams were making money. This year, from what I understand, there are only going to be a few that are not going to be in the black.
Pretty good.
I think that's what it's all about, isn't it, business?
But they said. Kevin McHale is checked in for the East. Mark Jackson to Daugherty, lost the ball. And a 4-on-2 again. Fast breaking to their heart's delight.
There you go.
Clyde Drexler from Worthy, and those two have teamed up for a couple of nifty fast break baskets thus far.
I think we were worrying about the team with the white shirts that they didn't have another point guard.
Mark Price, long lane. You know, except for Barkley, the East has not been able to work the ball that much inside. And Jackson will be fouled by Chambers. That'll be 3 on Tom.
Here we have Worthy doing his thing, coming down on a break. You must get to James because he can hit the stop and hit the jumper. Here's Clyde doing it.
And a timeout, 9:32 to go in the first half.
the great American race, the Daytona 500.
Jeep Cherokee is now exclusively available with four-wheel anti-lock brakes. This exclusive anti-lock braking system automatically reacts to any road surface condition, so in the event of a sudden stop, the response is controlled and immediate to all four wheels, a valuable option. But since Cherokee's a Jeep, it's not your only option.
Save up to $1,600 on select 1989 Jeep Cherokees.
Just how orange does Minute Maid orange taste?
Quack, 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 quack. Quack, 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 quack.
One and two, navel zip, and four.
Surprise!
Minute Maid orange. It's the orange orange in diet, too.
When Clyde entered his sophomore year in high school, he did not play that year. He went out and he said they were running and he was so exhausted, he said, I almost passed out. I said, really? He said, yeah. He said, I quit. I said, Clyde, come on. I said, you have to do this, you know, if you want to make it. The following year, he went out first one and he's been going ever since.
And you know, this is a special day because Clyde always wanted to play in the Astrodome because he has watched films of that Kareem Big E battle in 68 many times.
Clyde, we said earlier, the playground legend, Sterling High School star, University of Houston, two Final Fours, and left at the end of his junior year and has never looked back. Has been a tremendous star for the Portland Trailblazers.
Mark Jackson shooting the free throws now. Kevin Duckworth wearing double zero has come into the game for the West All-Stars, most improved player last year, also playing with the Portland Trailblazers. So they got a couple of big people in Eaton and Duckworth up front, and the rest of the lineup is Worthy, Mullen, and Drexler. Jackson misses both tosses, but wins the fight for the loose ball.
That's what Mark Jackson's all about.
Did he really challenge Eaton at 7-4? I don't believe it. Here comes Clyde. The glide, and no basket. I can't believe Mark Jackson. He has no fear.
Mark Jackson is the type of guy that he can be 2 for 16 in the last 6 minutes of the game, go 8 for 8 with about 7 assists and 3 steals.
You know, the West is on a 12-2 run in the last 4.5 minutes. They have their biggest lead right now of 22 points. Mark Price of Cleveland leaves it for Kevin McHale. Rebound is Eaton. You know, it's been, this is the first time in 10 years we've had as few as one Boston Celtic in the All-Star game. They didn't have anyone representing them 79. Good hook shot baseline, kind of a sky hook by Kevin Duckworth. Jackson quickly back down for the East. McHale semi-mugged, and it's going to be East ball still.
Well, with Eaton in there at 7-4, Duckworth at 7-foot, Worthy at 6-9, you're not bad up front.
Lenny Wilkins talking things over with Dominique Wilkins as Larry Nance connects, and it's 57-35. Wilkins trying to find the right combination to bring the East back and make this a semblance of a contest. The West have had their way.
Yes, but you want to give everyone their time.
And then the second half, as you said, that was James Worthy. Mark Price, double team, now Mullen. No one inside. It's just strictly perimeter right now. Now Daugherty camps in. McHale, familiar move by Kevin.
The best. When you talk about people who can play with their back to the basket with all types of moves, Kevin McHale is right there. Has at least 4 or 5 pets, and they're all very difficult to defend.
Worthy looking inside to Duckworth. gets his own rebound, blocked by McHale, good block by Kevin, and there is Mark Jackson. Drexler tries to block it, and Jackson uses his body to get the basket.
Not only did he use his body, he used the rim that time to dissuade Drexler from going for the block.
Oh. And Drexler tries a dramatic shot inside, out of bounds. It'll be the East ball again. This is what's going on inside the blimp. Boy, I hope he's, Aaron Jenkins is our pilot in the blimp, and I hope he's piloting the plane and not taking too many free throws.
Nice.
One for one for Aaron. McHale. Inside, and we'll have a foul against the West. Eaton might have pushed him. Kevin slowly getting up. The Celtics leading scorer with Larry Bird out of there. Here's John Stockton, who set an all-star record with 9 assists in the first quarter, and Clyde Drexler goes out. He scored 4 points. Michael Jordan back in there. Jordan has scored 8. Charles Barkley, the leading scorer for the East with 11, also is checked in. Eaton the rebound on Jordan's miss.
East, they're leaving all their jump shots right on the front of the rim. But to be fair with them, no team has had a chance to work out in this one.
Duckworth is fouled going in. Tom Chambers with 12 points is the top scorer in the game.
Keep an eye here now underneath on Barkley. Look at this. Do you think he wants his offensive board? I think he wants to back up his statement of I want 10 boards today.
He may get his wish.
Right now, the only thing that would taste better than a nice cold one is a cold filter one.
Can you draft anyone?
Thanks. Not a ton.
Because if you want a beer whose rich, smooth draft taste hasn't been changed by heat pasteurization, we've got it down cold. Cold filtered, more genuine draft. It's as real as beer gets.
This is $5,000
for the baby.
I'm embarrassed to be taking this. I mean, you could do something with it.
Like what?
What's something you and Mom would enjoy? Go on a cruise?
If your mother and I want to do.
Back inside the dome, the West leads the East 59-39, and hope you're enjoying the NBA All-Star Game, and we think you'll enjoy the Prudential at the half today. We have a few college scores and notes to catch you up on. Then we'll take you right on the court and show you yesterday's Legends game, three-point shootout and slam dunk contest. And who is Frank Layden and why was he here? A lot of people wondered that over the weekend, and we'll explain that and more on an All-Star edition of the Prudential at the half. And Dick and Hubie, it's been quite a week. Where have you guys been? We never see each other at these events.
Well, you're one place, Pat. You have your hands full working, and Hubie and I, what do we do, Hubie? What do we say?
I don't know, they called it interviewing, meeting and bumping, socializing.
Land-handing.
Yes, right. Uh-huh. A few.
You know, it's interesting, but we do, and you mentioned this to me before the game, we have an opportunity to see a lot of people that we don't see normally during our circuit around the league.
Absolutely, and it's nice to get the views of everyone of how the different ball clubs are doing and why they are doing it.
One free throw for Duckworth that time. Bring you up to date on who's in there because they all wear the same. East wears red, the rest wears white. Brad Daugherty is the center from Cleveland. Kevin McHale of Boston. Barkley of Philadelphia in there. Jordan of Chicago and Price of Cleveland. That's the team for the East. For the West, Karl Malone of the Utah Jazz and Hakeem Olajuwon of Houston up front. Dale Ellis from Seattle, Alex English, who just missed that shot from Denver, and John Stockton of Utah. Those are the five in there, the basket and the foul by Hakeem Olajuwon.
We just had a great defensive play by Barkley and blocking that shot by Alex on the baseline, but you'll see the block. Now, on the release, watch how Olajuwon is moving to get the ball, and it comes back up strong now. What I like about Hakeem, every time he makes his move to the basket when he's inside of 6 feet, he's going with both hands. Because even if you knock him, he's still got a chance at a three-point play.
Making his third start in a row as the center for the West, Barkley clashes bodies with Karl Malone. No pads, remember that?
Now, wait, speaking about guys who can draw fouls, this guy's right at the top of the league. We have Karl Malone, who's averaging 11 plus foul shot attempts in a game, and then Barkley at 10 plus.
What about the Sixers? If you look at Barkley, are you surprised that they have been above water as much as they have this year and playing as well?
It's a great tribute to Charles Barkley, what he is doing, and then also the addition of the two fine shooters in a trade with Anderson from Indiana at the small forward position, and also Hershey Hawkins as a rookie. And then how about the coaching jab by Jimmy Lynam and his staff? When you think that they have not had Cliff Robinson the entire season because of a knee problem, boy, that really underscores what they're doing.
63-40.
Hey, Carl.
Carl Malone with a hook shot in the lane, the rebound by Jordan. Jordan and company trying to bring the East back with just about 6 minutes remaining in the first half. Kevin McHale is just not falling for the East Stars. They've had opportunities. Ellis feeding Carl Malone. They are really running on the break beautifully thus far. Mark Price goes for a three. Out of bounds. Frustration thus far, an all-star frustration, I should add, for Lenny Wilkins, seeing his team really not getting underway as Isaiah Thomas checks in for Mark Price for the East. Wilkins said, this is a golden time for me. He says, what does it mean that you're in the All-Star game? He says, Cavaliers must be having a good season.
Yeah.
Elijah Wan, no good. Malone, Carl, good. 12 points for Carl Malone. He's tied with Tom Chambers for the West scoring lead. Prince Charles of the East has 12. And a foul against the East All-Star. And it'll be against Stockton, excuse me.
You know, you look at Karl Malone, you see him running the lane. He has been out now on four fast breaks. 6'9", 260. It's like he's made out of steel. He's worked so hard on his body, and he's just so proud of it because he said, I'm working hard, I feel I have the strength, and I also have the dedication. You know, that's kind of simple except for one thing. You know, he really believes it, he means it, and he's just backed up two sensational seasons.
Well, you have coached in the league, and those aren't cliches because it takes a certain special guy to have that dedication night in and night out.
Well, he feels so strongly about Frank Layden and the fact that he gave him his chance in Utah, and he wears Frank's name on the back of his sneakers. I mean, that's all it. He's a very, very genuine young man.
One free throw that time for Isaiah Thomas. Great feed from two teammates, John Stockton to Carl Malone, who now with 14 points. Stockton's playing a brilliant game in place of Magic Johnson, who's hurt. Kevin McHale comes back quickly. We still have not had the continual end-to-end pace that we know we will before this game is over. Inside to Carl Malone, guarded by McHale.
Well, all-star games are played in peaks and valleys.
Dale Ellis, who won the three-point contest, hits a three right here. And the West with a big lead of 72-43.
Look out. Stockton at his best. He's right in the top of the league in steals. Everyone knows that, except he's also there, right challenging with steals.
29-point lead. Barkley again. Barkley again. Third time's a charm.
He ripped that one right away from Akeem.
Inside. Good position for Carl Malone, and McHale blocks it, but there is an East foul as Moses Malone, who started the game at center, comes in for the East.
Watch Charles in the lower part of his screen. He just pushed Alex out of there, took that one. Watch him rip that one right away from McGee. Goes strong.
Brad Daugherty leaves the game, and he's replaced by Moses Malone, and Kevin McHale has picked up his third personal foul. So Tom Chambers of the West and McHale of the East each with three. What about the Utah Jazz? A lot of people think when all the dust is cleared, we get to playoff time, Utah could be the Lakers' biggest challenger. What are your thoughts?
Well, the big three do it night in and night out. And by that, I mean Carl Malone, John Stockton, and Thurl Bailey off the bench. They really have three outstanding players there. It's an excellent shot-blocking team, and they are the toughest team to have a high field goal percentage against in this league. And so anytime you have that going for you and you're unselfish, you get out on a break, you can challenge.
Thomas, scoop shot doesn't go. English with the rebound. Under 4 minutes to go in the first half.
Look at this.
Watch out. Akeem to Carl Malone. Akeem could have taken the shot. He passed it off. That's what they try to do in games like this.
Wasn't that pretty? I mean, first of all, John Stockton just made a 50-foot pass right on the money. Akeem makes a catch, gives a nice shovel pass. That's beautiful to see.
But it's a 31-point game, and nothing beautiful in the eyes of Lenny Wilkins.
Here's the pass. Here you go with it again. Now look at this. Seeing Karl Malone. And once again, Karl Malone running that outside lane.
He's got 18 points and is the game high scorer as we take a timeout.
If you ask every American the meaning of success, you won't hear the same answer twice. Whatever your idea of succeeding, Citicorp and Citibank can help. With Citibank MasterCard and Visa cards, Citicorp Savings, Diners Club, and Citicorp Mortgage. We also serve millions of customers in every major marketplace worldwide. Citicorp, because Americans want to succeed, not just survive.
So you didn't buy your Eagle Summit for the $500 cash back.
I bought it for its one-of-a-kind dual warranty. I'm not impulsive.
But you took the $500.
I'm not stupid either.
That double overhead cam engine in your Eagle Summit makes it pretty special.
Yeah, that's how I view it.
And how do you view the competition?
With mirrors.
The first time I started playing, we was fishing on Coney Lake, and they found a, I guess what you call a volleyball, and they brought it home, and they put him up a gold up to the house to play. Well, they played with it a while, and then it found on the seam, it busted. And so I took it and gonna pack it with some old pantyhose, but see, that still, it wouldn't bounce, you see. And so finally, I bought him a basketball. At the time, if it had been a post light up there all the time, they probably shot high for the night, you know. But you would hear him, that ball, boom, 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 all, you know, on into the night.
Here we have two guys, teammates, executing the pick and roll just beautifully. Stockton clearing the pick and roll. Nice two dribbles, allowing the defense perfect roll. Karl Malone, think about it, 85, the 13th pick on the first round.
Somebody could have had a gem earlier. Michael Jordan, there's the East coaching staff. Dick Helm, Brian Winters, and the head coach Lenny Wilkins. English with a turnaround. And the rebound by Moses Malone. The East has a long way to come back, but there is plenty of time, 3:23 to do, and Kevin McHale scores the record for the most points in a half. And there's a steal again, Michael Jordan to Moses Malone on a turnover, and the East in a flurry right now. It's still a 76-51 game. But you got to start from somewhere. The record is 86 points by the West in the first half of the 62 All-Star game. That was a game in which Will Chamberlain scored a record 42 points in a losing cause. Hakeem draws the foul inside.
Here's why Michael Jordan leads the league in steals. Great anticipation playing the passing lane. Then comes back and makes something happen right here. Beautiful pass. The one part of the game that they just never give enough credit to in regards to Michael Jordan's total picture, and that is his uncanny passing ability to put the ball on the money.
Hakeem Olajuwon makes one out of two. The foul was on Jordan, his Moses Malone, his first. Isaiah goes right by John Stockton as if he weren't there. So they have scored 8 of the last 10 points, the East Stars, and Barkley with a steal, trying to bring him back with 2:43 to go, and we'll have a foul on the West. There in the penalty. Foul is against John Stockton. So the East trying to get some back.
You know, when you look at John Stockton, you remember now last year he wins the All-State Good Hands Award, and that's for assists and steals minus turnovers. Huh. Very tough award to win.
Goes out with his third personal foul and is replaced by Clyde Drexler. Charles Barkley on the free throw line.
Well, they're taking him out of the game right now because they know that they're going to need him in the second half.
Barkley is the leading scorer for the East with that many points and 4 rebounds. Remember the promise he told his teammates. He'll come back with 10 or more off the glass.
You know, I kind of question the fact that he only has 4. It looks like he has that double figures.
I know. Well, we'll have to go through the archives and check to see. He makes another steal in the second. And the West gets it back. Olajuwon, they think it's a soccer game. Hakeem Olajuwon,
a big man's dream, right in the middle of the floor. Nice interception coming at you 3-on-2.
He doesn't do all that with Don Chaney's plan all the time. Thomas, it'll still be East possession.
See, in the first half, it just seems like the East is struggling because everything is hard to do. Everything is difficult.
And for the West, with all the fast breaks, it's the opposite. Michael Jordan, still East ball. Drexler touched it last. Chris Mullin, Golden State. Right now, if the season were to end, they would be in the playoffs. Moses Malone.
Nice.
Has it slapped away, and now the turnover, and it'll be the West with 2:08 remaining in the first half. We're at the Astrodome in Houston, Texas, 44,735, an all-star game record. A double Drexler, or try to. Michael Jordan playing safety position out there, free safety.
Well, they need a little flurry from the defensive end of the floor to get things going here in second half. Plenty of time.
Isaiah Thomas just inside the three-point line. Ellis the rebound. Drexler finds Karl Malone. Quick pass to Akeem. Outlet pass, McHale with those long arms and an easy unmolested basket. No, not Isaiah, but Michael Jordan.
That was so pretty because Zeke never turned around to take a peek. He knew he was coming down behind him.
22nd timeout called by Pat Riley.
Watch Isaiah now. Watch his head. See, he knows he's behind him. He just throws it up there. Ah, beautiful.
And it's great to see those two doing it particularly.
Nice pitch out by Kevin McHale to make it happen. See, Zeke, he knows he's behind him.
That's what you can do in these all-star games. And the East on an 11-3 run in the last 3 minutes have cut the lead now from 31 now down to 23. Isaiah Thomas, most valuable player in this game in 1984 and 86. He has missed only 9 games in 6.5 years. I mean, he's not incredibly well built, but how durable?
Durable. And more important, he wants the last shot.
Clyde Drexler.
With Zeke, you never question his courage. He'll take the responsibility of winning or losing the game on his shoulders every night.
Drexler almost does a runover job on Isaiah Thomas and helps him up. We're at the Astrodome in Houston, Texas, the view courtesy of the Goodyear blimp, as we are here on CBS Sports for the 39th annual All-Star Game. 81-56 the score. The West has been fast breaking. The East has struggled a bit. Karl Malone with 18 is the high scorer in the game. Barkley leads the East with 15. Drexler committed the foul and Thomas in the penalty shooting.
Isaiah Thomas and Magic Johnson are the two youngest players ever to play in this game. They both played at 20 years of age.
Brad Daugherty was the youngest last year and still may be the youngest. He and Mark Jackson are 23 years old. The East has connected on only 10 of 19 from the free throw line. Ten seconds on the shot clock. That's the first time he mentioned the clock today. And English from the corner. Jordan, forget it. And Ellis got a hand on it. The Eastern Conference shows a different look now that the Boston Celtics have struggled without Larry Bird. Right now, Boston is the 8th qualifier and 3 games behind Philadelphia. Now, New York, even though they are behind Detroit in the standings, would get a second slot if they win the Atlantic Division where they're leading right now.
That means that Cleveland would play the 8th place team. New York would play the 7th place team. Even though Detroit has a better record, they would have the 3rd seed in the conference right now.
And now you get to the second round, and we're looking way ahead now. Now the records in the regular season do determine the home court advantage. But you know, it's the Central Division. We talked about it last week in the Detroit-Chicago game. Really, 5 of the top 11 teams in the league are from that division. Dale Ellis misses Drexler. Finally makes good on his 3rd attempt.
Well, you have to be impressed. The West team really hustling on the offensive boards.
Isaiah Thomas lays it in. 8 points, so they've got 85 points, and the next basket for the West will break the record for most points in the first half, and it's 22 seconds, so it may get close. Elijah Wan misses, tapped up and in by Ellis, and we've got an 87-59 game and a record set by the West All-Stars. 87 points, the most scored in a half in NBA All-Star game history.
At the East End, we're seeing an awful lot of sensational attempts, but no cigar.
Payoff not there. Out of bounds, it'll be the East ball with 4 seconds to play. A rousing 87-59 score. Lenny Wilkins will want him to have fun. He'll say, enough of the fun, now maybe we'll play. That's the end of the first half with the score. West 87, East 59. Pat O'Brien will return with the Prudential at the half after this message. It's the big All-Star weekend in Houston, Texas, the NBA's Big Bash. CBS Sports brings you the 39th annual NBA All-Star Game from the Astrodome in Houston, Texas. At the conclusion of today's game, a panel of writers and broadcasters will select the Miller Lite Most Valuable Player, and in conjunction with the award, Light Beer will present a check in the amount of $5,000 in the player's name to the Texas Special Olympics. Miller Brewing also made a special presentation earlier today when Robert Toledo, Vice President of Brand Management, presented a $5,000 check to Dennis Poulos, Executive Director of the Texas Special Olympics, in the name of Michael Jordan, top vote getter in this year's All-Star Fan Voting. Miller Brewing will soon be initiating efforts in the state of Texas to raise $1 million for the Special Olympics, and today's $5,000 donation is the down payment towards their million-dollar effort. Hubie Brown, I just had a chance to talk to Lenny Wilkins, and I said, well, you know, it won't count against your record with the Cavaliers if you don't win this game. He says, you know, we're shooting terribly. It's 41%. He says the combinations may be right, but they're not going in, and they're not getting back against the fast break.
Well, we said at the top of the show, you always worry about defensive balance, but you can't go to the foul line, miss 11 foul shots, shoot 40%, and only have two of your regulars do anything at all. Barkley and Michael Jordan have nice stats, but give the credit to the West. They have been unselfish. They're running the floor. Karl Malone, Dale Ennis really doing it, and then Tommy Chambers off the bench with a big 12.
Those are the people to watch. Malone with 18, Ellis 14, two others in double figures. The West starting team is in there. The East has a different group from the five that started the game. Next time they have the ball, we'll fill it out for you. John Stockton misses outside, fighting inside and getting nearly the basket was Hakeem Olajuwon. That looked like it might go in. Steal, they were all over Ewing, who gets called for the goaltending.
Well, it's been the story of the game. The East keeps getting second shots, but they're not making any field goals, but the West makes everything count.
Isaiah Thomas with the ball and Michael Jordan at guard. McHale, Wilkins, and Ewing up front. Ewing tries to slam it through to no avail, and here comes the West again.
Look at this.
Karl Malone around McHale. Looks like they're getting every second shot as well, Hubie. Ellis that time. Karl Malone. Rebound. Ewing. Michael Jordan to Dominique Wilkins. A brilliant pass. No-look pass. Let's take a look at the Eastern scorers thus far, led by Charles Barkley with 15. He has 4 rebounds. Nance leads the rebounding with 5. Dominique Wilkins is on the line.
I won.
Wilkins was born in France. His dad was in the Air Force. Did not compete in the slam dunk contest, Dominique, yesterday because of the thumb problem.
He said he made his first dunk in the 9th grade when he was 5'8". I always thought he could dunk forever.
When he was an infant.
Yeah, late bloomer.
And that pass goes awry. So the East right now looking like they're still out of sync passing-wise. Turning the ball over. 89-62 to score as the West, with 87 points, set an all-star record in the first half. Most points in the first half of a game. Crowd filing back into their seats now after the halftime intermission period. There's a nice steal by Wilkins. He Anticipated Ellis's pass. Michael Jordan to Dominique Wilkins. That's a combination that could bring the East back.
Ah, the last two trips down, Michael has made two beautiful passes on semi-spins.
Got to be a slow comeback if the East is to make one at all. They've won seven of the last nine games in the All-Star Affair. Six on the shot clock. Dale Ellis in the corner gets Carl Malone. And he's fouled by Patrick Ewing. Let's take a look at the West scorers. Four players in double figures. The top rebounder is Carl Malone. He's off to a terrific start. And keep in mind, John Stockton had nine assists in the first quarter and 10 in the game.
Well, the West shoots 60%, and they also shoot 87 from the foul line, making 14 out of 16. Kind of helps the situation.
Yeah, the East was 4 for 14 on the line in the second quarter alone.
Always when you come back, you must come back on the foul line and the gimmies, the easy shots.
Kevin McHale of the Celtics, Patrick Ewing of the Knicks, and Dominique Wilkins of the Hawks, the front line. Thomas of the Pistons, Jordan of the Bulls. Watch out from behind, Akeem and Isaiah playing free safety. Comes right back. Goes by Stockton. Goes by three others. Goes by everyone. Gets the layup.
Nice stutter move by Zeke that time. I want to say something about Akeem Olajuwon. Everybody takes him for his scoring, his rebounding, and his shot blocking. But he is second in the NBA in steals to Michael Jordan.
For a center, that's phenomenal. There's a steal by another center, Patrick Ewing. Isaiah Thomas surveying the land. McHale. Short that time for Patrick Ewing. Carl Malone. Stockton, Ellis, Alex English. The way he leans forward. There is Akeem Olajuwon with a turnaround stuff. He's in double figures with 10. 92-66. No contest at this point. And Michael Jordan slides through to his 14th point. Ellis. You know, you've talked so much about spacing. I think the West spacing has been great offensively, spreading everything out.
They're running the lanes well, and Stockton is pushing the ball. He's forcing them to get out and open up. But you must like the rebounding. One shot for the East. They get the ball out. There they go.
You know, that was a 4-on-1. That might have been the easiest fast break the West had all day. Right. And they lost the ball. McHale, Wilkins. Oh. I believe this.
Stockton gave Dominique a little hip action that time. But Dominique, be fair to him, he's having a lot of difficulty holding on to the ball at the right hand. It's the right thumb. Consequently, he can't get up to really dunk.
Dale Ellis quickly turns it around. Rebound by McHale. It's a 24-point game. Great pass to Jordan. Is that Thomas?
That was a highlight.
Oh,
baseball, one skip pass.
And the two of them with a medium five on that one. That was a great one bounce pass.
Watch how he threads the needle here. Now you'll see the rebound. Here's Kevin kicking out to Zeke as he looks up. There you go. The long bounce. One skip hop.
Who was your favorite shortstop?
I was an Alvin Dark guy, I have to tell you.
All right. I like that.
I'm known for my gentle and charming disposition. So when Ernie here ran out of Miller Lite, I didn't get mad. Nah, we calmly discussed the situation. I told Ernie I drink Lite because it's brewed from the ground up, so it tastes great. Not like some watered-down version of a regular beer. We reached an understanding, and he quickly rectified the situation. Mom always said I had a way with people.
When it's Miller Lite, less filling, tastes great.
A6, hurry and you'll make it.
Delta Airlines ticket agent Sam Singletary knows how to get people moving.
Mr. Franklin, you're back.
But sometimes he has to show off a few moves of his own. The kind of moves that made him a first-string halfback. Sam Singletary shares a feeling with everyone at Delta. He loves what he's doing. And it shows.
We love Thanks. To fly.
He's the kid.
And it shows.
You've seen those Chevy versus Ford tests, right? We came up with one of our own. Half-ton 4x4s, best available tires, driven at the same identical speed right through this 18-inch deep ditch. Now, this is a real control test, so don't you try it, because you'll damage your truck. That's the Chevy with torsion bar suspension, and that's the Ford with twin traction beam suspension. And you can see why we've had a change of heart and pickups.
That's today's Chevy truck.
The injustice, the anger, the fears, and the men who've seen too much.
You're gonna have to be brave here, Jack.
But through the madness, some things keep getting hotter. Tour of Duty Tuesday.
Whenever they went out to play, the people who he played with would come and tell me how brilliant he was. The coach in Angola saw him, saw his activities, how he's playing. Uh-huh. He was there. He advised him that he will have to take him to abroad.
That's phenomenal. Parents in Lagos, Nigeria have to be so proud of what Akeem has accomplished in professional basketball. That's a great treat to see them talk here.
In such a short period of time, you know, his family runs a cement business, and you look at Akeem, he's all NBA, all defense the last 2 years in a row, first team.
John Stockton feeding Olajuwon, and Akeem hits from outside. 12 points for Olajuwon. 96-72, 24-point lead. McHale at the top. Now the basket's starting to come for the East. They're shooting much better, as you knew they would.
Well, Kevin had a nice first half. He was 3-for-5 from the floor and a lot of key rebounds there for them. And they made that little run, semi-run.
Heads up.
Starting team for the West that began the game in there now. Here's Olajuwon again with 7 seconds on the shot clock, Ewing in his face. Malone, that's off the mark. Here's Isaiah Thomas. Nothing down court. 4-on-2. Beautiful pass to Ewing. And Patrick Ewing gets his second basket of the game.
That was a sensational fake by Isaiah. He looked to his right. Here we have Zeke throwing this ball on that one bouncer. But hey, how about the catch at the other end by Michael Jordan on the dead run? I don't know, Buddy Kerr.
Pee Wee Reese. Okay. Out of bounds. It's still the West ball. Isaiah Thomas, by the way, with 11 assists in the game. So the starting point guards have done, and you pointed out, it's a ball handler's kind of game. Stockton and Isaiah Thomas both in double figures in assists. Alex English over Dominique Wilkins. Tough shot over Wilkins.
Wilkins was right there. As a matter of fact, you could hear the click. He really did get a piece of that shot.
McHale trying to work his way low post against Malone, and it's taken away by Carl.
Look at this. Look at him in the outside lane.
3-on-2.
Yes.
Basket counts and a foul. Stockton and Malone, and Isaiah Thomas winds up behind the press.
Come on. I mean, is he out there?
Yes, he is.
Whoa. Great play right here by Carl Malone. As he gives it up, look how hard he's running in that outside lane. We told you in the first half he was on the end of four of these. Look at this.
21 points for Carl Malone. A lot of gifts from John Stockton as well. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar is into the game. He has yet to score, was in briefly in the first half. 3-point play by Carl Malone. Kareem was in for 5 minutes. Actually, the West team has four centers, Olajuwon, Kareem, Eaton, and Duckworth on their squad. Turnover, and Boomer Esiason, Super Bowl runner-up Cincinnati Bengals, and a fine season for the Boomer this year. Charles Barkley enters for the West or the East All-Stars. Kevin McHale goes to the bench. Kareem, skyhook. Drexler follows it up. But I hope we see a skyhook from Kareem before this one's over.
I do too.
He's in for the volume of work, for the great work over the years. Forget about what he's done this season, and he's starting to play a lot better. Said he didn't deserve to be here. No way he doesn't deserve to be here. Ewing bites his way in, and Kareem gets a piece of him.
How about Stockton? Stockton is so pesky. He's right down inside, reaching in, trying to grab everything. You know, he's only 6'1", 175 pounds.
But when you're watching him, his quickness of getting from the top of the one circle to the other end of the floor to the top of the other is as good as anyone in this league. Plus, the defensive player backpedaling knows that you must guard him because he will stop on a dime and take that three-point shot.
Here's Patrick Ewing at the line. Misses the first free throw. James Worthy, who hit all three of his field goal attempts in the first half, has come in for Akeem Olajuwon. Or make it Alex English. Kareem replaced Akeem. Rebound right into the hands of Thomas. Ewing struggling from the line in this game. Feeds Barkley for the two.
Charles is having a monster game. He already has 17, and we think he has 15 rebounds.
They say four.
They only had four.
It's four. It's four. Still West ball. And the West, of course, already over the 100 mark. It's a 103-78 game. And Drexler of Portland will be feeding in. Karl Malone of Utah, Stockton of the Jazz as well, and two Lakers in Worthy and Kareem. Nine on the shot clock. Drexler looking in, and it's right into the hands of Michael Jordan. He wanted to go to Abdul-Jabbar. Stockton tried for the steal, but it'll be East ball. He's all over the floor.
He's everywhere. Stockton, the energy level is incredible. Now watch this pass by Patrick. Takes the defense up, and it drops off inside to Charles. See what you see about Charles? He turned his body to the baseline that time. He's so smart, because if you're going to block a shot, you must come over his back, you foul him, and then he takes you to the rim for the potential 3 points.
Karl Malone goes out with 22 points, the game-high scorer, and Tom Chambers replaces him. Mark Price has gone in for that man, Michael Jordan, who goes out with 16.
Uh-oh.
Thomas lost his footing and is called for the foul.
So I was concerned that time, Dick, because Isaiah stepped on a shoe of another player, and it looked, you know, it looked like he twisted his ankle. He's all right.
He's got the smile on his face. There's the pass to the opposite side of Dominique Wilkins. Barkley fights for the loose ball.
And referee. I mean, he's doing everything. A little rebounding, a little refereeing, a little scoring.
Up, 103-78, under 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Dick Stockton and Hubie Brown here in the 39th All-Star game. Ewing. The rebound is by Drexler. Worthy filling the lane on one side, Chambers on the other. And Drexler fights his way in, second shot. 12 points for Clyde Drexler. Homecoming for Drexler. And he has 9 rebounds to boot. 3-point basket for Mark Price. There are the high scores of the game. 105-81, 4:20 to go in the third period. East has won 7 out of 9. West, though, trying to make it 2 out of 3. Another hook attempt by Kareem misses. East trying to get back. Barkley says, "I'll go for 3," and misses miserably. Drexler to Chambers. Price can't stop him, and Chambers with 14 points.
Here he is.
Yeah.
Now Thomas, they're going to bring Chris Mullin in, the West Stars. Dominique Wilkins. And it is not deflected.
Okay, that's why.
And now Dick Bivetta says it was. So here's Chris Mullin coming back in the game. John Stockton goes out. And Larry Nance comes in for Dominique Wilkins. The West is on an 11-4 run in the last 5 minutes. Moses Malone returns at center, replacing Patrick Ewing.
Moses has been in this game 12 straight years. The only year that he didn't make it was the first year of the merger.
Pretty good.
Yeah, everyone forgets. Everyone thinks Moses went to college. You know, he's straight out of high school into the NBA.
One of three ever to do it. Daryl Dawkins.
The ABA. ABA first, then the NBA.
But into pro basketball, Bill Willoughby and Daryl Dawkins were the other two.
Right.
Want to clarify something while we have a moment here as we look at Isaiah Thomas. You remember the shot of Brendan Malone and that Isaiah Thomas put his hands around his neck. I'm sure people saw it on the news highlights and sports highlights all of last week after the Chicago game. People were under the interpretation that Isaiah was going after Brendan Malone. He coached for you, and that's not the case at all, is it?
What happened is that Brendan Malone and Isaiah Thomas are very close friends. And as Isaiah was walking down the floor, Brendan ran across the floor and kept telling him, Zeke, you cannot get thrown out of the game. You cannot get thrown out of the game. We need you. We need you. And because the game was going into overtime. And what happened was is Isaiah, who was still really miffed that he was split open because he took six stitches that time, just wheeled and put his hands on him. And then when he snapped out of it, he bumped head with Brendan and said, Brendan, I'm sorry. He said, we need you. And it was great because it's a coach and a player understanding one another. It was just a reflex action by Isaiah.
It looked a lot worse than it was. Worthy misses a three and the rebound by Moses Malone. I'm glad we had a chance to set the record straight.
Oh,
Thomas!
Yes.
Who did he throw that to? It couldn't have been to himself. That was a nifty play. Fine play by Isaiah Thomas. Tries for the steal. Doesn't work. Chris Mullen pops and hits. Chris Mullen. Good outside shooter. And Don Nelson, when he was talking about Mullen, says, you know, that we need Mitch Richmond with him because the two of them operate well together. One without the other, not quite as effective.
That's right. Feeding off one another because they can beat their people off the dribble and they can play inside or outside.
Larry Nance, former Phoenix Sun. 109-87. 22-point game at one time. The West led by 31. The East trying to chip away with 2:28 to go. Here's a three-point attempt by Kareem.
Why not?
Why not? And I root for the guy. You want them all to go in. Price comes back and nails two. So now it's 109-89. So it's a 20-point game with 2:12 to go in the third period.
This unit out there trying to get by with Drexler and Mullen in the backcourt.
Here's Worthy posting up. Price knocks it away.
Nice. 3 seconds.
Mullen blocked. And it's off the knee of Worthy, and it'll be the East ball with 2 minutes to go.
Well, here we have Isaiah coming down. Now watch how he slows up, and then he passed the ball to himself and brought it right back.
Can you do that in the All-Star game?
Yeah, but how about the fact that he shot it with his left hand?
Oh.
The Great American Race, the Daytona 500.
I was lucky. I was 6'10 and good at basketball, so I got a scholarship. But like a lot of black kids, without a scholarship, I couldn't have afforded college, which is why Miller Lite and the NBA have co-founded the Thurgood Marshall Fund, the first fund created to improve public black colleges and help finance their students, so any kid who wants a good education can get one, even if they don't grow up to be 6'10".
Support the Thurgood Marshall Fund, because a future should be something everyone can afford.
You've been hearing a lot of news recently about the importance of including whole grain in your diet. But of these leading cereals, only one is made from 100% whole grain. Only Wheaties. So only Wheaties gives you whole grain nutrition. And maybe that's why only Wheaties has Michael Jordan. Better get your whole grain.
You better eat your Wheaties.
Who says Chevy beats Ford? USAC tested Chevy's compact S10 with available Vortec V6 against two full-size Fords with standard 6 and available V8. 0 to 60, towing identical trailers, Chevy S10 beat both full-size Fords. That's pickup power.
And if a compact Chevy S10 with a V6 cannot accelerate a full-size Ford with a V8, imagine what it can do against Ford's little truck.
The heartbeat of America, that's today's Chevy truck.
It's 109-89, the West leading with 1:54 to go in the third period. A fine array of sports next week at 1 o'clock Eastern. CBS Sports Saturday takes you to Oslo, Norway for the Men's World Speed Skating Championships, plus Simon Brown defends his IBF welterweight title against Jorge Masonette. Then it's the Daytona Twin 120 follows to fives, followed by NCAA basketball, Kansas versus Duke. Next Saturday. Right now, let's go to James Brown. JB?
All right, Dick, with the man that many consider to be the best defensive back in the NFL, Ronnie Lott. Ronnie, they build these guys as the world's best athletes. Now, I know you're a great one yourself. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, I have to agree with that. I tell you, when I see some of these great athletes out here explaining these slam dunks and doing all the things they do, but probably the best athlete of them all is not here, and that's Magic Johnson. He does so many great things, and he's a friend of mine. I know you would love to be here. We've had a great time, Magic.
Well, all right. Talk about a good coach right here in Ronnie Lott. Let's go back to Dick.
All right, JB, thank you very much. By the way, Monday's the big day for Magic Johnson. He'll be examined by Dr. Robert Kurlin. Get an idea how long he may be out. Terry Cummings of the Milwaukee Bucks misses from the corner. And it's now the West ball. It could be as much as several weeks if that tear is more than just a partial tear. But on the other hand, things seem to be going well, according to Gary Vee, the trainer, and he may be back sooner than people expect. The Magic. Man, Magic Johnson.
He's going with two small guards now, Price and Isaiah in the backcourt.
Inside to Moses Malone, and they'll jump it up. Tied up by Kareem. Michael Jordan on the bench has 16 points. Still Barkley with 17 is the East leading scorer. James Worthy. 109-89, 20-point game, favor of the West. They've led virtually all the way. East had a 2-point lead in the opening moments, and that's been it for them. Kareem, sky hook, still no cigar. Rebound, Nance. Kareem set his all-time scoring record in an All-Star game last year. Thomas misses. Moses Malone goes up again. That's what he's known for, the basket and the foul, Hubie. Well, we mentioned that Lenny Wilkins, of course, is going into basketball's Hall of Fame. So is Casey Jones, the great coach of the Boston Celtics, now the vice president of basketball operations. Those two, along with Pop Gates, who is part of the New York Wrens barnstorming teams of the 30s and 40s, the three of them headed for the Hall of Fame.
Well, Lenny Wilkins was so appreciative of the award. He wanted to go all the way back to his days at playing CYO ball. Oh, he knows me. And Father Mannion, that's how far he took us back.
Pretty good, yes. He went way back. Thomas on the steal, got the basket back. This is the first time that the East has been under 20-point deficit since a minute and a half of the second quarter.
In a game like this, there's plenty of time.
Always time. East is on a 13-2 run.
The building wants Kareem to knock down the hook.
And Isaiah Thomas stripped the ball away from Tom Chambers. Thomas to Moses Malone, stuffs it through with 6 seconds to go. 109-96, it's a 13-point game. Kareem, foul going to the hoop with 2 seconds to go. And a chance to break into the scoring column in this game.
He had the block shot, beautiful block shot that time. Combination of Nance and Terry Cummings. Now you'll see Isaiah, watch how they come right back down the middle to Moses. Nice.
I gave Thomas the credit for that, but you know what? I think he was the beneficiary of the loose ball by the two big men. Kareem gets his first point of the game.
Well, he's left a couple of the sky hooks right on the front of the rim. A few more opportunities, he'll get it done.
Played in this arena against Elvin Hayes in a game that perhaps put college basketball on the map in 1968. UCLA-Houston battle. And that'll do it for the third quarter. The East is coming back. That's the end of the third period with the score, the West 111, the East 96. And we'll return to the Astrodome after this message and a word from your local station. Skyline of the city of Houston, Texas. The NBA All-Star Weekend. And what a weekend it has been. Capped today by the 39th annual NBA All-Star Game. From the Astrodome in Houston, Texas, where a record crowd of 44,735 witnessing the 39th game. And the West has had the lead all the way virtually. The East, however, has cut the West's lead almost in half from their biggest margin of 31 points, 111-96 as we get underway in the final period. The West Stars have Mullen of Golden State, Drexler of Portland, Eaton of Utah, Worthy of the Lakers, and Chambers of Phoenix out there. And James Worthy hits.
All that good defense. The East actually came out in a little trap situation that time. But because they kept fooling around, they end up getting beat with a medium-sized jumper.
And a steal coming right back. Cummings, the only defender. And he makes the defensive play to Mark Jackson, who's in the backcourt along with Mark Price. Jackson of the Knicks, Price of the Cavaliers. Price is way short on the long range shot. Moses Malone stays in there, the center team from Atlanta. Drexler flies in for two more. He's got 14. Two of the Cavaliers, Price and Nance in there. We haven't seen all three of them yet. Price misses Eaton. Knocked away that time by Nance. It'll be the West.
Mark Price a little uptight with himself right now. Oh, come on.
Well, you know, she may put it in the put it in the bank for the West, you know. Games have come back. I think it's a she. I don't know. 10 on the shot clock. Worthy. Drexler, straight pass.
Drexler has been moving exceptionally well this half. He's following every shot up that's coming off the board. But when they're hitting the pivot people, he is cutting. Very strong. He's got a lot of size on the guards.
Tom Chambers misses. Mullen tries to keep it alive, and Price gets it to Mark Jackson. Behind his back to Moses Malone. Double teamed. Eaton got a piece of it.
See, you can pump fake all you want with Eaton. Eaton just stands there. He never leaves his feet, keeps his arms up, and then after you're finished with all of your moves, you make it. He just takes it away.
You don't think Pat Riley and the Lakers hate playing against that guy? Not to mention other teams, but he presents a huge problem.
Never mind the fact that he's 7'4". He's so wide.
Cummings, with a nice turnaround, is in the scoring column. Only Brad Daugherty, and Brad Daugherty really the only player who has not scored for the East. Mark Eaton hasn't scored for the West.
Nice deal.
Otherwise, everyone's in the column, and they'll call a foul against Clyde Drexler. Well, we took a look before at the Eastern Conference and that setup. Let's take a look at the West, where the Lakers still have the best record there, and Houston and Utah in a battle, and the winner of that division will automatically get that second seed. But look at Phoenix and Seattle. The Pacific division's come on.
Oh, it is, and it's exciting right now because of the incredible job that Phoenix did. Seattle just coming off a long road trip, so they're going to be tough. But watch out now, because Houston has many, many road games in this next month coming up.
Kevin Duckworth and John Stockton have entered the game for the West.
Nice.
Beautiful pass. Mark Jackson, Larry Nance connect.
Beautiful pass. Mark Jackson, great eyes. He's bounced the ball through his legs here today, behind his back. Great court vision.
Broke Oscar Robertson's rookie assist mark. And then John Stockton,
who were
our guests in the pregame, comes right back with two. 117 to 100, 17-point lead, and another play, Mark Jackson to Cummings, and maybe Lenny Wilkins has the combination he wants.
Well, he was looking, and he's gambling, going with all point guards now in the second half, but they're getting the distribution of the ball.
Duckworth banks it off the glass. So every time the East starts to make a move, the West retaliates. Jackson for two, just inside the line.
Like we said, how many shots have you seen Jackson take today? But now all of a sudden the game is getting close. Money's on the line. He's taking it.
Isn't that a fact? He has to be doing something right for the Knicks to have the phenomenal season they've had.
He's fronting down here, a little arm wrestling with Drexler.
Duckworth. Rebound Cummings.
Yeah, they get one now.
8:45 to go, a lot of time, and that pass just past Mark Jackson's stretched arm.
Watch on this pass area here. Now watch Mark turn, suck up the defense. Nice shovel pass. See, when you make them, you want to make it an easy shot for the recipient.
Lasso and Longhorn is one rugged event. And after roping, we drink Miller Lite. Because Lite's a less filling beer that's brewed from the ground up. Not some watered-down version of a regular beer. Lite's a beer for guys who lasso Longhorn. Longhorn semis, that is.
When it's Miller Lite, less filling, tastes great.
The hard part's rolling it over and tying it up.
It seems like yesterday the Millier girls were in their strollers. Today things are changing. I'm State Farm Agent Dee Ray. After Shannon and Stephanie came along, the Milliers needed our family insurance checkup. I showed them ways they could update their family coverage to cover their bigger family. Like every State Farm agent, I work with a family to help keep their insurance up to date. Keeping up with the girls, that's their job.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Introducing the all-new Plymouth Acclaim.
to have fuel injected power. Available room for six. Over 50 standard features to combine the best of all worlds. Takes a world beater. A world beater to satisfy the customer. The new Plymouth Acclaim proves the nine most important words Plymouth knows.
Last year, the Blue Devils were favored to take it all, but the Jayhawks took it all away from them. Kansas Duke, the rematch next Saturday.
In a sophomore year in high school, they had a team made up of all sophomore kids throughout the city of Spokane, and they went back to Frankfort, Kentucky, and they got to play against some real good competition. And then the following year, as a junior, John went, and he played against Isaiah Thomas, who was playing for Chicago at the time. And they had a real duel. Isaiah won, but he played against the best juniors in the nation. And thought, well, he did all right against them, so he could play. And I think attitude-wise, that was a big stepping stone for him.
Well, we have Isaiah. Isaiah made a great compliment about John Stockton's game. He said he's a joy to watch and hell to play against.
Mm-hmm. And it was Stockton who broke Isaiah's single-season assist record. Two of them have tremendous respect for one another, and out of Gonzaga, you know, and it looked like Utah really had the beeline for him. They really had scouted him out, knew what they wanted. And he comes and meets the ball.
Here's a trap.
And it worked. Cummings, Nance got it to Price, and the two Cleveland Cavaliers team up.
Hey, Lenny Wilkins, that little rascal, is going to half-court trap.
And he's using his own players to boot. Although Brad Daugherty is not in there, Moses Malone remains at center.
But he does the trap out of a timeout. That's nice.
James Worthy's had a big shooting game, tipped by Nance. Drexler, one-handed fall away. Who wants the ball? Mark Jackson. Behind his back a couple of times. Jackson takes it in. Out of bounds, and it is still East ball with 8:03 to go.
You see, Lenny's taking a try. Here comes Nance up on the right side of your screen. They double team right at half court area. At each timeout, you'll see both coaches from now to the end of the game. They'll run a set play, and they'll run a specific type of a defense.
The lead is down to 13, and it could have been 11 had that fallen, and Akeem Olajuwon has checked in for the West All-Stars. Pounding the glass, Moses Malone gets it to Cummings. Mark Jackson to Moses behind him. Out of bounds, and it'll be East ball as Dale Ellis of the Seattle Supersonics comes in, and Clyde Drexler gets the breather. Riley is 2-4. Here's a steal. This time by Mark Price.
Two of the best in the league at stealing off the dribble.
Cummings is fouled going to the hoop. You know, Pat Riley is 2-4 as a coach in the All-Star game, and not many guys even get to lose four games, huh?
Here. Watch this steal. Here he comes. He gambles for the bounce. Beautiful. See, and what he did, he anticipated Stockton crossing over to switch from his strong hand to the outside hand that time.
Olajuwon's foul, and they're going to bring Alex English of the Denver Nuggets coming in, replacing James Worthy, and Terry Cummings on the free throw line.
You know, he touched on Cummings earlier, Dick. You know, in talking to us, he said that, you know, he is revitalized. He feels he has a lot of energy, and he credits that to the development of Larry Krystowiak, who has really taken off a lot of pressure on him because he can play the big forward some nights and get a little bit of a rest, where Krystowiak will go out and chase these people at 6'10", and the front line is doing a great job.
Cummings, the second pick after James Worthy in the 1982 draft, picked by San Diego. 119 to 108, 11-point game with less than 7.5 to play in the fourth period.
Nice.
Ellis from Stockton. Dale Ellis, he has 18 points. Carl Malone with 22 leads the gang, and Mark Price's foul going to the line. Houston, Texas, the scene of the big All-Star weekend festivities. That's the Astrodome. And a record crowd, 44,700 plus inside, 121-108. The West had a lead as big as 31 points in the first half, and the East has chipped away. Can make it down to 11. That's as close as they've been since early on. Here's Brad Daugherty replacing Malone So now, Hubie Brown, we have the three Cleveland Cavaliers in together for the first time today.
Are you hinting at something?
They know how to play together, and their coach is a Cavalier. Why not, right?
Why not?
Two free throws for Price. He has 9. 11-point game, and with 7:06, it's an incredible comeback for the East Stars. Cummings fouled Duckworth. Next Sunday, huge day on CBS Sports. The Boston Celtics against the Los Angeles Lakers. Live at 3:30 Eastern time from the Forum. Rockets and the Cavaliers on Monday, February 20th. So we have two NBA games for you next week, and you'll get a chance to see the Cavaliers, the best team in the East on Monday, and the Lakers, the best team in the West on Sunday. Timeout with 6:56 remaining in the fourth period.
Teamwork makes winners. The All You Can Be, sponsored by the U.S. Army. Magic Johnson and James Worthy use quickness to set them apart from the rest of the league. Magic changes gears to shred a fierce defense, while a quick first step allows Worthy to streak past desperate opponents. By pooling their explosive styles, teamwork has made Magic Johnson and James Worthy the best they can be.
If you want to land a good job, you have to know what most employers want. Like how to motivate yourself, how to lead others, how to perform under pressure. You can learn all these things in the Army. So no matter what career you choose, you'll really be ready to take off.
The fastest men on wheels in the great American race, the Daytona 500, next Sunday.
Well, we have seen some of the spectacular in this 39th annual All-Star game, Hubie Brown, and it's interesting that the reason they keep score is because somebody wants to win the game, and now they've cut 20 points off the deficit from 31 to about 11, and now it's an interesting game, and I don't see the smiles on the face of the players anymore.
Now, we have plenty of time. We have close to 7 minutes to go. And what I like now is that Michael Jordan is coming back in this ball game, and we all know that he does have a tendency to take over sometimes.
Sometimes.
And can do the magical as long as with the sensational. And he's going to get the calls in once we get into pressurized situations. We know that. But it's interesting that Lenny is pairing him up with Mark Jackson, because Mark Jackson is playing excellent basketball in this half.
He is setting a lot of people up and getting inside the paint. Stockton is all over Mark Jackson. Gambling with Dale Ellis. Jordan draws the foul and hits the floor as he is sandwiched between Duckworth and Karl Malone, or Hakeem Olajuwon. Foul on Duckworth.
You know, you look at Michael Jordan's game and you say, you know, he takes a lot of shots, but here's a man who shoots 54% from the field and 84% from the line. And if you are going to have a guy take a lot of shots, let's have someone with those kind of credentials.
Who makes them? Karl Malone, you saw, came in. Malone replaced Duckworth. Isaiah Thomas is in for Larry Nance. So three guards in there now for the East, with Jackson, Thomas, and Jordan, with Cummings and Doherty the only big people.
Well, they'll play Jordan at the small forward position right now, and they'll match him up with Alex English.
The Western Five, who started the game by virtue of the Miller Lite fan vote, are all in the game right now. 121-112, a 9-point deficit. Last time the East got it under 10 was 4 minutes to go in the first quarter, but John Stockton gets the big hoop.
See, that's what makes him special. Once he goes down that line, you can't jump back off of him because he can score.
Cutting to the basket is Jordan from Isaiah Thomas. He went backdoor around Alex English.
You always go backdoor and give that extra effort when you're playing with unselfish guys, because you know the ball will be right there.
Winding down to the halfway mark in this fourth period. 6 minutes to go, 123-114. Here's Mark Jackson.
Oh, come on.
Fouled by John Stockton, and they can cut it now to 7 points, and the East has made one huge comeback here.
You'll see Isaiah here find it. There goes the back door. Beautiful bounce pass. You like to throw the bounce pass because it gives the cutter who's going back door that there's a defensive man between him and the passer. When the ball is bounced, that gives him an extra hundredth of a second to pick it up off the floor.
John Stockton with his fourth personal foul, and here's Mark Jackson. The East have had their problems from the free throw line. This afternoon, they are 22 of 35.
See, when you're out there, you're a young player, and if someone tells you that you're a step too slow, please look at the guy on the foul line right now, because everybody's been telling them that ever since he's been playing the game. If you have a big heart and you see the floor and you can deliver the ball and play some defense, there is a place for you.
Mm-hmm. They didn't say Chris Mullen was very fast either. Two St. John's teammates. Olajuwon and Daugherty keeping away from the hoop. It did not take a good shot. Ellis' second effort. And the basket will count and a foul. Good defense by Brad.
Oh, excellent defense by Brad. He pushed Olajuwon behind the board. There was no way that that shot could go in. But once again, the second guards from the West, either Drexler or Ellis, on the offensive boards.
What about Seattle as Ellis is on the line? How do you look at that club right now?
Extremely good defensively. They've got their East Coast trips out of the way now. Playing great basketball at home. And, you know, they've got the necessary guys who can score on that ball club. And then when you have Xavier McDaniel coming off the bench, you got a hammer.
Turnover. And it'll be West ball. Cummings, by the way, for the East has four personal fouls. 126-116, so the lead is 10. It was 7 a few moments ago. Malone just inside the three-point line, hits the basket, 24 for the game-high scorer, Karl Malone of the Jazz.
If you've never seen Karl Malone play, you would say, gee whiz, can he make that shot? He's always been able to hit that jumper facing the basket.
He led the West with 22 a year ago, and he's topped that in this game. No-look pass and a deflection into the hands of John Stockton. 4-on-1 to Dale Ellis. And the West, seeing the challenge from the East, now trying to come back. And there's another turnover sparked by John Stockton. Karl Malone, yes. He made the basket good. And a foul as well, as Olajuwon hit the floor. Big play by the Jazz combo out there.
In this sequence now, watch how they run the floor. John Stockton at his best. See, he's got great eyes, good court vision, head up. Here you have Ellis, boom. Now, right back as they went the opposite way, Stockton makes a key play and made it happen again at the other end of the floor.
Being neutral, the Swiss enjoy the best of all worlds. Cars from Italy. Clothes from Paris. Shoes from England. And from America, Old Spice Liquid Stick, a new antiperspirant. With the smoothness of a roll-on and the speed of a stick, it also combines the best of all worlds for total protection. After all, nothing's more important to the Swiss than good relations. Old Spice Liquid Stick, the world's most advanced form of protection.
The whole family came over for the weekend. I took pictures of relatives I didn't even know I had. Naturally, I looked for the Kodak Color Watch seal for great developing. The Kodak Color Watch system, you're gonna thank me for it. So will my cousin. I don't know who this dude is, but he eats a lot.
Introducing the new 1990 Plymouth Laser RS Turbo. To have 190 horsepower, to go 0 to 60 in 6.6 seconds, to make car and driver's 10 best before the first one was sold, takes a world beater. A world beater to satisfy the customer. The all-new Plymouth Laser RS Turbo proves the 9 most important words Plymouth knows.
A recent Department of Energy study reveals that most American homes are under-insulated. And that means you. To find out what's right for your home, call Owens Corning at 1-800-GET-PINK.
From Norway, the world crowns its speed skating king of the ice. From Hungary, the IBF crowns its welterweight king of the ring next weekend on CBS Sports Saturday.
All right, look, we're going to run a clear out for Michael. Isaiah, come down, just pass it to the forward, slice off of Brad to the corner, right? Give it back to Brad here, okay? Michael, you'll be down here, okay? The other forwards here, okay? The other, you'll be here, the other guard is. You'll be here, the guard is here. Just come up to see the screen, guard go off.
Flare out for Michael.
Well, what they're trying to do is they want to get the ball in the hands of their best passer that they feel as a big man in Brad Daugherty. And that way they can get the center up high, and they'll try to clear out and pop Michael to the right side of the floor. Let's see if it happens.
Karl Malone on the free throw line. By the way, John Stockton has already chalked up 16 assists. The All-Star game record is held by Irvin Johnson with 22 assists in the 84 game, the game that went into overtime. So Malone missed the free throw, made the basket prior to that. It's 132 to 116.
Here's your clear out.
And there's Michael Jordan's basket, just
and
as he drew
your
it up.
Basket.
Is it that easy, Huber,
yes,
the coach?
Course,
I didn't know that.
Players have nothing to do with it.
The West had scored 9 in a row after the East had cut the lead to 7. And then came Jordan's hoop. Inside to Akeem. Knocked away by Jordan, the steal by Isaiah Thomas. He's tied up. But Cummings on a 2-on-1 gets it off the glass. He does that every day, right?
Of course.
Terry Cummings has 8 points.
Isaiah Thomas, yeah, smarting that time because there was a good collision at half court. Stockton almost restole that pass.
Lead is down to 12, 132 to 120. Dale Ellis buries one from outside. Ellis has 25. He is second to Malone with 26 in the game high score.
There are very few guys who can shoot catching the ball going away from the basket like Dale Ellis.
Good pass from Thomas to Mark Jackson, who hits a three. You're right. You said it earlier, Hubie. You don't have to look at me
I'm
with your arms
you.
Out. I know you're right.
I tell you, talk about courage. He has courage to make the big play under pressure.
Karl Malone gets his own rebound and lays it in. 28 for Karl Malone. 136-123, 3:19 to go. Cummings short. Rebound by Ellis. We're getting into that MVP thought range, Hubie Brown, and we'll have to start thinking of that.
When you catch Terry Cummings in the middle here, now there's a live mad scramble. Now just watch as he looks left, gets it off the wrong foot, but then has the presence, knowing that because of the angle, he should bank in the shot. That is very hard to do from that angle.
So as we get close now, with 3 minutes just about remaining in this fourth period, you know that Karl Malone and John Stockton and Dale Ellis loom large for the West Stars for possible MVP. Stockton hits a three. John Stockton only 11 points, but he has 16 assists in this game. Jordan is the leading scorer for the East Stars with 123. Try to get the pass inside, tipped away. Now it'll take a huge comeback by the East. They gave it their all. They were down by 31, cut it to 7, and then the West scored 9 in a row to open it up again, and a timeout call with 2:25 to go. And a 16-point lead by the West All-Stars, who have lost 7 of the last 9.
When we played for Oakland, we did not appreciate losing.
Our motto was, just win, baby.
Yeah, but now we just like to play a quiet game of pool and drink a few cold Miller Lights.
Lights brewed from the ground up, so it tastes great.
Not like some watered-down version of a regular beer.
Your turn, Otis.
Hey, you cheated.
So?
So, nice shot.
When it's Miller Lite, less filling, tastes great.
Time for the All-State Good Hands Award. Based on his total steals and assisted turnover ratio in the month of January, for the second straight month, John Stockton of the Utah Jazz had the best hands in the NBA. And this nimble pickpocketing of Darryl Walker is just one reason we can say, good hands, John. That's the All-State Good Hands Award. And remember, you're in good hands with All-State, a member of the Sears Financial Network.
If you've got yourself a car and you've got yourself a house, you could be on your way to some very nice savings. Because with Allstate Homeowners Insurance and an excellent driving record, you could save up to 15% on your auto insurance and 15% could mean big money for all the important little things.
What a day.
What a day.
The Allstate Auto Advantage. Another reason. A member of the Sears Financial Network.
Next Saturday at 1 o'clock Eastern, CBS Sports Saturday takes you to Oslo, Norway for the Men's World Speed Skating Championships. Plus, Simon Brown defends his IBF welterweight title against Jorge Masonet. Then is the Daytona Twin 125s, followed by NCAA basketball. Kansas against Duke. You know, they've met in the Final Four in the past. That'll be at 4 o'clock Eastern. Fine menu of sports at 4 o'clock Eastern next Saturday. Well, this is going to be the twilight, the final moments of the last All-Star game for one of the greatest ever. Maybe the only honor he never achieved with all the records was to be an MVP in an All-Star game, Hubie.
Yes, but as you look in the record books, and then when you think back, is the high school record, the record at UCLA, the championships in the NBA, the MVPs. I mean, come on. I mean, the list is just a knockout.
Michael Jordan from the corner with 2:15 to go has 24 points. I'm glad he was here, and I know you felt the same way. He deserved to be here. I don't care if he hadn't scored a point all year.
Well, I think all of the players felt that way also, and it was kind of nice to see that.
Dale Ellis with a turnaround, 27 for Dale Ellis. Kareem didn't think he should be here. It was fitting. Isaiah Thomas with a three. Zeke, as they call him, with 19 in the ball game. Under 2 minutes to go, and Kareem will be coming in to finish this game. He is at the scorer's table, and he's going to make his final All-Star game appearance to finish out this 39th Classic. Alex English wide open. Carl Malone keeps it alive for Hakeem Olajuwon, who throws it away, but there is Malone again inside. Here's Kareem coming in. And the crowd gives him a fine ovation. Hakeem goes out. The new star, here's the old one. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar with 2 points, but that's meaningless. The symbolic aspects of him being in this Astrodome game now. Out of bounds, they turn it over to the West. By the way, Hakeem Olajuwon with 12 points and 7 boards. Clyde Drexler replaces Dale Ellis. Mark Price replaces Isaiah Thomas. 1:17 to go, and the West will have won two of the last three, and Pat Riley will improve his All-Star coaching record to 3 wins and 4 losses. Michael Jordan open court with that tongue out. Jordan with 26 points.
Toughest thing, we said at the top, for any coach is to take 12 great basketball players and divide up the minutes and keep everyone happy. Impossible.
Crowd's got to be happy.
Oh, yes.
Hubie, what have you enjoyed about this All-Star game as we come to the end of it?
Just being a part of it. This is a happening. It's the big dance of the year. Everybody's getting a chance. And just to be around everyone, the feeling has been so warm with everyone. Mixing, it's nice.
Mark Jackson keeps it alive. Brad Daugherty off the glass. Terry Cummings banks it in. Jordan with 28 leading the East, then Isaiah Thomas with 19, Barkley with 17. Those are the high scores. McHale and Cummings each had 10. Chris Mullin and John Stockton will go out of the game, and he should get a good hand. 11 points and 17 assists for Stockton. He had 9 of those assists in the first quarter to set an All-Star game record.
And to keep up the pace that he was doing, you know, when you're talking about the pace of this caliber. Here's the hook.
All right. Yes! That's all great. Right. Standing old.
Wonderful.
He hit the sky hook. What a fitting ending. Michael Jordan misses a three with 5 seconds to go. And that'll do it. Game is over, and the West moved out to a big early lead, were threatened, and then came back and put him away. And Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, in his 18th All-Star game, connects on his last shot, a skyhook, in the waning seconds. And the players congratulate each other. And we will return to learn who is the most valuable player of this 39th All-Star game, won by the West, 143 to 134.
I was in agony. I hurt all over. The doctor said there was no permanent damage. He gave me a different medicine. It's in these little yellow Nuprin. Got rid of that pain. Know what else? It works great on my tough headaches.
Nuprin. It's not aspirin, not Tylenol. It's ibuprofen.
Two Nuprin stop my headaches better than extra strength Tylenol. And Nuprin's gentler on my stomach than aspirin.
Nuprin. Little, yellow, different, better.
It even worked on my worst pain.
People are succeeding in business thanks to desktop publishing. Makes you look pretty smart, doesn't it? Only thing is, what if you need 5,000 printed just as nice for that big meeting? Now, how are you going to get that done? Huh?
When I'm fighting dandruff, I want all the help I can get. So now I'm using new Extra Strength Denerex with 39% more dandruff medicine. For my dandruff and itch, there's 39% more medicine in new Extra Strength Denerex. For great-looking hair, I can't get too much of a good thing.
Back here at the Astrodome in Houston, Texas, Dick Stockton and Hubie Brown, we want to remind you that tonight on CBS begins with 60 Minutes. It was a former U.S. Marine corporal telling the truth when he said he spied for the Russians, then he said he didn't. Did he or didn't he? Find out on 60 Minutes. Then it's Murder, She Wrote, followed by the CBS Sunday movie, The Outside Woman, starring Sharon Gless and Scott Glenn. That's all tonight on CBS. Who is the most valuable player of this All-Star game? Right now, let's go to center court and Pat O'Brien. Pat?
All right, Dick, thank you very much. Of the 24 greatest basketball players in the world, one has been singled out. And for a presentation, here's Commissioner David Stern of the NBA. David?
Carl, on a day when the greatest players in the world gathered, you were the greatest of them all. 28 points, 9 rebounds. Congratulations, you've earned this trophy. Now you can pick it up.
Carl Malone, ladies and gentlemen. Bob Toledo from Miller Brewing Company has some remarks. Bob, a presentation.
Miller Lite, in your name, we will contribute $5,000 to the Texas Special Olympics. Again, from Miller Lite, thank you for a great performance today.
Carl, congratulations. Did you ever dream of winning an MVP in this game?
No, I didn't. I was just blessed to go out and do a good job and stuff like that, but I felt pretty good and stuff. It's really good when you see John Stockton on the other side, so I think John should sure have this MVP, but I just want to thank everybody that's been supporting me. I know people don't know where Utah at now, but it's in Salt Lake City.
They know where Utah's at by now, I think. It was nice to see John. You're looking for your mother, Shirley. We're going to try to get her over here, but you guys came out smoking and never looked back, did you, the Weston?
Well, I did an interview with Isaiah before the game, and he said that they was going to beat us, and they did in Chicago, and it's good for the West to win, and this is my second time here, and I think it's the most exciting time, and, you know, I'm just really excited about the whole situation.
Carl Malone, congratulations on being the greatest basketball player on earth on this day. And we'll be back in a moment, but first, here's Dick Stockton.
All right, Pat, thank you very much. So Michael Jordan with 28 leads the East. Carl Malone, the MVP, the top scorer for the West with 28.
You're looking sharp.
A record crowd of 44,735 at the Astrodome sees the West win the All-Star game. So for Hubie Brown, Pat O'Brien, and James Brown, this is Dick Stockton saying so long from the Astrodome in Houston, Texas. Next Sunday, the NBA on CBS continues as the Boston Celtics clash with the Los Angeles Lakers at 3:30 Eastern. Next Saturday at 1 o'clock Eastern, CBS Sports Saturday takes you to Oslo, Norway for the Men's World Speed Skating Championship plus an IBF welterweight title bout.
CBS Sports coverage of the NBA All-Star Game has been sponsored by Plymouth and the 9 most important words Plymouth knows. Old Spice Liquid Stick, the most advanced form of protection in the world. And by Miller Lite. When it's Miller Lite, less filling, tastes great.
is a presentation of